僕は普段あんまりゲームをしないんですね。それでゲームが嫌いってわけでもないんですけど、例えば車だったら実際の車を運転した方が面白いし、バイクならバイク、今はビリヤードで、その現実の中に普通にゲームするより自分にとって面白いこと、楽しいことがたくさんあって、で逆にその現実にある面白さをゲームの中で表現して、で、例えばモトクロス、バイク、車の面白さ、スピード感、臨場感っていうのをゲームで表現してみんなに届けようと思ったり、まあそういう発想で、セガ時代はずっとやってました。ちょっとした、現実にあるちょっとした面白いことってありますよね。なんかこう笑っちゃいけないところで笑っちゃうとか、なんか怒られてんのにおならが出ちゃうとか、もう本当に子供らしいっていうか、なんかちっちゃな子がやりそうなことでクスッと笑えることとかってあると思うんで、そういう現実のちょっとしたものが入ればいいですね。もちろんファンタジーとか SF みたいなものも昔から好きなので、そっちの方にも興味はあります。ゲームの表現力ってすごく上がってきてるんだけど、その一方、その CG で比較されるところって映画と比較されたりするじゃないですか。で、映画っていうのは2時間の決め、大体2時間の決め打ち、しっかり仕組まれて、ここで起承転結もここでぴったり、で、ここで、こう、静と弱とか、こう、静と動とか、弱と強とか、こう、エモーショナルに、こう、ジェットコースターみたいにこう作っていくと。それで、その落差で感動を、っていうのが計画通りできるんですよ。で、ゲームは、その、ゴージャスなゲームになると、RPG タイプのゲームになると、30時間も遊ぶ。そうすると、30時間のクオリティと同じ予算で、その2時間の決め打ちとだと、やっぱりそのそつなく30時間をこなしていかなくちゃいけない。で、代わりにインタラクティブっていう強みもあるし、ビジュアルじゃない強みもあるんだけど、やっぱりそういう面で言うと、表情なんかは、やはりまだまだ映画の方が上になってくるんで、30時間アベレージに、キャラクターの表情を保てるようにするには、やっぱりプログラマブルに制御できるようにならないと、到底その映画のクオリティ保つっていうのはちょっと難しいだろうなと。僕がこう実際に手を動かして、僕はプログラマーなので、まあ今ディレクターとかプロデューサーもやってますけど、若い時はプログラマーだったので、プログラマーである限り、なるべくそのプログラムで解決したいなと思ってたんですよ。だから、絵なんかも、まあちょっと勉強したこともあって、少しは描くんですけど、自分でこう絵を描くよりは、自分の思考を、まあ簡単に言うと簡単な AI みたいなもの、自分の思考を AI に覚えさせて、その AI に絵を描かせる。っていうことをやって、で、俺の代わりに俺の不完全な作った、自分の AI の、不出来な AI が、不出来だからこそ予想外の絵を描いてくれる。絵って言っても、油絵みたいなものを想像してもらってもしょうがなくて、例えばスプラインを使って、で、時々とかにぶつかって跳ね返ったり、こう、まあなんか、焼き付き防止で、今、ちょこちょこ、PC のとこに出てくる壁紙みたいなやつありますよね。ああいった類のものだったり、しますけどもね。
コロナ禍で何が大事かなっていうのを考えた時に、 あのゲームって一人じゃ作れないですよね。まあ、集団で、だ今チームで言っても50から、まあ、多い時で100とか、まあ、そういう体制で、ゲームを作ってるんですけど、やっぱ大事なことは、僕らは客商売じゃないですか。最終的にはお客さんに届けなきゃいけないっていう中で、この隣にいる人、まあ、そのリモートだといなかったりするんだけど、その隣にいる仲間が何を考えてるのかとか、何がしたいのかっていうことをしっかり思い合って仕事を進めていくってことが非常に大事だと思うんで、まあ、週1月曜日にまあ朝礼とかしてるんですけど、まあ、その時に同じような話もするんですが、隣にいる人の気持ちをそのきちんと考えて、相手のその立場に立ってものを考えて、そのコミュニケーションを取るってことが、まあ、すごく基本なんですけど、小学校の時に言われてたようなことなんだけど、まあ、一番大事なんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
まあ、すごい強い女性なんですけれども、まあ、体も大きい、なんですけど、すごい能力あるけれども、まあ、必ずしも幸せに生きてきたわけではないですし、その人間としての悩みもあれば、まあ、いろいろなリアリティがあるいうところで、普通の人間であるはずの主人公が、特別な、まあ、まさに、なんて言うんだ、その能力を買われて、いつでも死んでしまうようなミッションに放り込まれる。で、そこの辛さっていうのは当然あるわけですけど、まあ、これを決してその怖いよ怖いよって当然言うわけじゃなく、すごいどしっと構えて、少なくとも表面的には動じない様子で戦い続けるし、そこにそのヒロインの人間としてのハードボイルドな魅力がにじむ、そういったゲームというか、キャラクター性ですよね。強くて、まあ、美しい女性であるっていう魅力で、同時にすごく人間臭いところが実は中に秘められてて、でそれを表に出さないからハードボイルドな魅力にすごい満ちている、そういうクールなキャラクターですね。はい、そこが魅力だと思っております。はい、と思うので、もちろんこだわりどころとしては、僕らあのアクションゲームずっと作ってますから、そのアクションにおいてはすごいこだわりありますし、で昔からあのカットシーンとかそういうストーリー演出も僕ずっとやってきてる、そういう経緯もありまして、まあそういったストーリーテリングもこれも頑張ってやってやりきりたいと思います。はい。
Today is a bad day for Dower. Investors need to take a big leap of faith that the millennials and later generations will forego ownership of a synthetic and opt instead for reliance on orthodox substitutes. Synthetic workforce will continue to be used as a convenient supplement.
Ed-1120, time for your appointment. Lieutenant Stone.We hope you enjoy the accommodation. This is your ticket out of here. I know that your schedule is super busy these days, but maybe you'd care to listen.
Hi, I'm Fimarie Zimmermann. I'm portraying Hannah for Wanted Dead. I'm already doing now, oh god, I have to recount, like for 10 years modeling? It's 10 years? Sì, sono 10 anni, vero? Sì. It's 10 years now that I'm modeling, and I started 2 years ago with Wanted Dead, or with the casting of Wanted Dead, and the modeling part was always like, I enjoy it because what I can do with modeling is what I'm not doing daily. And just, you know, like, I don't know, maybe sometimes being confident and doing these kind of things, or changing the character. Even that, it was something you don't want to be daily. And for thanks to all these experience, all the years, I said, okay, actually, what I like is this kind of acting, to jump into another character. So why not to really try into becoming an actress? And then 2019, this casting of Wanted Dead just came out, and I was like, okay, it's a video game, never done this before, and it's acting, it's recordings, it's a lot of stuff altogether. But I said, okay, let's try it. The script and all about it, because it's actually, it was like kind of the longest script I've ever seen. Also because being like the main character was a lot of work, I have to say, I have to be honest. And before the video game, before we started rehearsing, before everything, I was thinking like, oh God, I'm never gonna make it. I have to be honest on that. But I enjoyed it. But I was really, till the end, till the first day of the recordings in Frankfurt, I was still thinking I'm not gonna make it. Because it's more like you're nervous, you're meeting new people, and it was the first time actually recording for a character for a video game. So I was having no clue on what was happening. I had a perfect rehearsal, I have to be honest. But I was there and was like, okay, you know what? I just gonna enjoy it, I'm here. There's something new popping out, and we have the chance to, how can I say it? If something goes wrong, you are gonna be always able to make it better. Hannah is actually a badass katana-wielding Hong Kong police officer. And yeah, she's a crazy bitch, I would say. But on the other hand, this is what she's showing, she's trying to show. On the other hand, inside her, she's super sensitive and trying not to show it, but with the guys she's feeling more comfortable with, you can actually feel it and see it in action. Where she's, oh, there's coming out more and more and more. And this is what brings you to what also brought myself when I was reading the script to, I want to know more about her. And I was actually getting more connected to her. And the thing what you will actually see, or yes, will be this, what I call mother instinct. And which most of women actually have already naturally, will come out slowly out by going through the game. And this is one of my favorite part about her, which makes her, how do you say that, vulnerable, and but on the other side also pretty strong. Yeah, this is what I can tell you about Hannah. The most challenging, I cannot say the word. The most challenging scene, I guess, we had a lot of short takes, and I had always some issues with the short takes. I didn't really have the problems with the long ones. Yeah, I had some issues before, but it was like, okay, I'm gonna kill some people. On the other hand, it was like, okay, let's do it. I loved that karaoke part. I don't really had the clue on how to put a karaoke in a video game. So I was like, okay, let's do it. And with Vivian, we had a lot of fun. And we were together in the same room. It was super tight and it was super warm. And we were just, okay, let's go for it. And we actually really felt in like a karaoke bar. Yeah, it was amazing. You know what's missing here? A cooking show.
Hey, it's your girl. Michael, Vivian, niemands verdriet. And today we're doing something special. Tonkatsu. I know, pork is not that easy to come by, though the synthetic substitute in a store near you will do the trick. But before you feel like you're chilling in Ginza, my producer asked me to read one of your letters because we're getting so many. Gunther Storch writes, Dear Vivian, my name is Gunther and I'm death row inmate B2155 at the Zakatsky Island Maximum Security Prison. I've been a lifer after the war, but when I stabbed the warden with a makeshift stiletto, they decided to give my stay a free upgrade. On Sundays, we all watch your show, and some of the folks leave the TV room in tears. It's too heavy on them. Each night, when I close my eyes and fall asleep while listening to the waves crashing on the walls of the castle, I'm dreaming of your warm and juicy chicken salad. I have this episode on rewind. I wonder if this could be my last meal. With love, your biggest fan, Gunther. This is so sweet, Gunther. I hope you make it till the end of next season because our new sponsor arranges sweepstakes. Madre de Urus Russos, because everything is hotter in Russia. And now, tonkatsu. For tonkatsu, I would highly recommend using fresh panko, breadcrumbs. Don't buy these. Take your white bread that is on the older side and put it in the blender. Medium heat. Now we wait while the oil gets hot.
Did you just forget?
We really want to have our tonkatsu nice and flat. This is my favorite part. Beat the devil out of it. Salt and pepper. Be generous. Whisk the eggs. Seriously, it's so easy, a child could do it. And burn his face off. Give it a minute. And flip it. Nou, zie je wel, maar Gunther houdt wel van mijn kookkunsten.
Ja, hij zou het eilandje van de avocado pakt eens een keer moeten proberen. Dan gaat hij zich vast nog wel bedenken.
Richard. Actie.
Now we take the cutlet out. Dry off the oil. With a few paper towels. And let it rest for a moment. Remember, there is a lot of cooking going on, even if you're not cooking. This is not me making this up. This is science. oil, nice and hot. Let's give it a minute more. Delicious. Don't just look at it. Eat it.
Simple. My name is Dasha Rash. I'm electronic producer, and I speak with sounds mostly, not words. It's a language. I mean, a sound is everything for me. It's also, I guess, my personal essence of existence somehow. I don't know. It's, I mean, maybe it's too philosophical or something, but yeah, I guess it's just, that's why I want to leave or something like this. Not only, but it's just the main element in my life somehow. Well, I define myself as an artist in terms of, like, if you have to put a frame, let's say sound artist, but also because I work with other disciplines, so let's say just an artist. But, you know, it's very large term, you know, there's a lot of different types of arts and different disciplines, as we spoke. So, but yeah, I would say I'm an artist, but actually internally, I would say I'm a sound poet or something. Like, but that's, you know, it's very abstract, I think, for people. Like, you can't say, hi, I'm a sound poet. I mean, in terms of combining the disciplines, because, I mean, music is the language, also poetry is the language, you know, to expression or to something, and then dance is a language. So, I mean, I'm generally interested in art in different forms. So, and even though my, let's say, primary field is music and sound, but I do have some sort of fascinations for other disciplines, and how, like, when I work with dancers or the visual, like, make audiovisual projects where I combine, but it always comes from the music, even though the scenario, but then I would write a script how to visualize that particular piece. So a combination of disciplines, you know, and like, if you speak a different dialect but you talk about the same thing. You know, like, I speak with music, and then the dancer speaks with his or her body. But then we talk about the same thing in a different ways. And then the combination of it can be even stronger. there's a film about semantics, how the sound impact on the matter. And there is a speech, I mean, of course, it's a little bit theatrical, but so the speech says, like, the sound is everything, basically the vibration. It's like the physical part of sound. So it's not only music. I'm just fascinated with sound. So it's not only the language, it's also, like, you know, the vibration. I mean, it could maybe sound a bit esoteric, but it's actually not. It's a physical impact. You know, the frequencies, everything, how you know, like, if you have a vibration, some sort of frequency, I have some sort of frequency, like, I believe in that. Yeah, performing arts is something else. It's like a aspect of what I do, but it's, I would still say, even sometimes it takes a majority of my time, but still it's not the essence. Or no, I couldn't say it's not the essence, it's just one of the aspects. Like, my favorite part is still sitting in the studio and creating, like, producing, even if it fails and doesn't go anywhere, like the actual process of creation. Because when you perform your piece, lives a different life. You have to let it go. Like, you have no control. You perform the piece, but then it's for the audience to take it, to interpret it, to, so, like, once you on the stage, it doesn't belong to you anymore, you know? It just, you let it go to, for other people, and then they take it and whatever they want to do with it, destroy it or appreciate it, or I don't know. Yeah. So the right balance, I like the right balance. Like I like to be in my bubble, but I also like to expose my bubble afterwards when I'm done. So yeah, the right balance. I like it both. But still, like the, let's say the most intense process is when you're alone and when you're just about, you know, or you're getting somewhere. It's the most exciting moment. But when it's done, it's already, like I told you, it's a different step. From the moment you, okay, it's finished, it's, it goes somewhere else. Like that, but the moment of creation and where you actually, oh yeah, you're getting there, you're getting there. It's like, you know, you can sit alone and go, oh, you can listen to it the next day and say, oh no, what have I done? You know, so it's, yeah. But I think I like that intimate process the most. But still, I need different aspects to feel complete, of course, because I think it's important somehow for, I guess, for every artist to show your work, because you can't keep it for yourself always. I mean, that's the main question, like, does art exist if nobody sees it? Like, does the piece exist if nobody sees it? So, yeah, both. Yeah, both. Gay music is pretty new to me. Like, I didn't have much experience in the game industry in general, but I mean, something similar or like a smaller project that was related to games, or but I guess the company didn't survive or something. But yeah, so it's a new, relatively new field to me. So the, I mean, for now, I'm on the stage where I just made the soundtracks, not the complete sound design of the game yet. But that's something that I'm definitely interested in, like film music scoring games or films, or even working, you know, for a theater piece that is not mine. Like for now, I still have most of the projects are mine, even though it's a theater, but I still is in my kind of, but also collaborating where I just, let's say, interpret musically someone else's idea. That's it's interesting for me, like the new collaboration. And then, I mean, gay music is pretty new, so I don't have much to tell yet about it, like of my experience. It's a new collaboration, and let's see where it goes. I told you, like, I'm interested in different collaboration experimentation. It's also nice where, you know, you have someone else's story. Like the game has a story, it has a mood, it has a characters. So once you learn all this, you kind of try to imagine how it would look like or how it would sound like. Like if you read the book or watch the film without, like, muted film, you could imagine how, you know, sound-wise. So it's the same. It's like that's my interpretation, how I see the character and the whole what been described to me, how would that sound? Like the, you know, the kind of dystopian thing, and, you know, kind of the character, the female character, and the mood of it. Even though, obviously, I haven't seen the game in a full version, so there are bits and parts that I had to assimilate and make my own image. So it's very interesting, like telling or adding to someone else's story, but in a language of sounds, how that image or that character or the whole picture looks like or sounds like. So it's very interesting. Yeah, there is this beautiful darkness in it. Like, it's dark. I would say it's dark, you know, but it's still, it's not like a trashy, ugly dark. There's this beauty in it. So that's, I can only talk mood-wise. I cannot tell you specific elements, because that's how I work. You know, that's, it's the overall vibe, the frequency. You know, that's what I was referring, like the frequency of a personage that I got it. So a beautiful darkness. Yeah. So, but that's how I see it. That's how I see a combination between the action, just like beside the action game, but also in within the character. It's, even though it's virtual character, but it's based on some human aspect. So it's always, there is always a contradiction in the force and the opposite, and like, yeah. Beautiful darkness, beautiful darkness. like the human. Yeah.
そのやっぱ日本のクライアントと違って結構そのハードコアなゲームを目指してる。日本って結構カジュアル路線だったりすることが多いんですけど、パブリッシャーさんってすごいワンテンっていうのはハードコアなゲームを目指すんだっていうのを最初から一貫して熱いこだわりを持っていて、で僕らもずっとその難しいアクションゲームとかを作っていたんで、そういうところはすごいスムーズにやり取りができて、まあ同じようにハードコアなゲームを作るんだっていうところは同じ志を持ってすごいいい感じに進められているなって思っていて、であと結構ゲーム部分はそうやってハードコアっていう一本筋を通して、まあ、あの大きな方針を立てて、一緒の道を歩んでいけてる感があって、でそのシナリオ面とかもやっぱそのオリジナルの IP を打ち出していくんだっていうところですごい熱いこだわりがあって、そこは僕らはそんなに口出しをせずに全然あの向こうの魅力的な世界っていうのを、まあ、作っていこうっていうところで、そこの熱い思いとかはちゃんと受け止めて反映できてるのかなと思っていてっていう感じですかね。結構そのハードコアが、なんだろう、日本のクライアントだとやっぱカジュアルカジュアルっていう話とか、カジュアルの定義とか、まあ、すごい難しかったりとかする中で、ハードコアでいいんだこれはって言って進めさせてもらえるのは結構楽だったりはしますね。はい。
Welcome to Kepler, a Jovian exoplanet, also known as Earth 2. 300-something parsecs from our homeworld, and you're here. The colonial administration guarantees careers, and not jobs, and takes pride in going the extra mile to support the ever-growing colony. Wellness programs, office perks, health insurance, performance bonuses, paid sick days, retirement plans, gym memberships, stock options and equity, paid parental leave, child care assistance, and get this, diversity program. At least, that's what the booklet says. By the time corporations figured that there's literally no natural resources on this rock to justify the space travel hurdle, it was already too late. They just had to pull the plug. Goodbye, Dynamic Solutions. Bye-bye, OmniGen. Ciao, Dower Synthetics. Some settlers were given a choice. You either leave or wait until the next big thing. Well, my grandparents decided to stay. Now, you either work odd jobs or you're a farmer. Can't say that I hate agriculture, but there's only two ways to get off of this planet. You either find a treasure map and become a gazillionaire. Or you win the race. I guess I wasn't cut out for prospecting.
そうですね。あの企画を考えるときって、こうみんなこう楽しそうだなとかって思ったものを、まあもちろん企画やるんですけど、結局なんていうんですかね、あの触ったときにそれが面白いかどうかって別の話なんですね。で、その面白い要素を詰め込めば面白くなるかっていうとそうではなくて、やっぱりその面白さを引き立たせるためのものであったりとか、あとゲームって一番何と他のメディアと何が違うか、他のエンターテインメントと何が違うかというと、インタラクティブ性があるっていうことが一番大きいんですね。なのでインタラクティブ性のところ、まあ、触り心地であったりとかっていうところをまずこれクリアしないといけなくって、でその企画の面白さとか絵作りはまあ結構重要なんですけどっていうところだけ考えていっちゃうとですね、そういうところがこうゲームの部分とかっていうそういういろんなものがおざなりになっちゃう時があって、でそのまとまった時に一つにまとまってるかどうかっていうのはすごい重要なのかなというふうには思っています。まあいろいろあると思うんですね。人によっていろいろあると思うんですけども、こういうロジックがあって、こういうことを今度試してみたい、でこういうことをやったら面白いかどうか、ある程度遊びを頭の中で構築したときに、自分なりにこういうところが面白いなっていうふうにやっぱり一回やるわけですよね。でそれをさらにその作ったときにそれが実現できてるかどうか っていうのはすごく重要 で、それが実現されて思い通りであればそれは成功ですし、ダメだった時にじゃあどういうふうに立てた、まあ、作り直すわけじゃないんですけども、どういうふうにそれをもっと自分の理想に近づけていくのかっていうことを試行錯誤していくっていう、まあ、フローがあって、その面白さに近づけていくっていう、まあ、そんな感じなのかなというふうに思ってます。ただ不条理にやっぱ難しいゲームってやっぱりダメだと思うんですよ、僕の中では。なので不条理ではない、自分の腕にチャレンジしてくるゲームがあって、そのチャレンジを自分の腕が悪いからいけなかったんだっていう風にそのフィードバックくれるゲーム、はい、僕ハードコアなゲームでもそういう作りのものがやっぱりいいんじゃないかなっていうふうには思ってます。まあゲームの可能性というか、まあ、ゲームは僕の中では総合エンターテインメントだと思っていて、でインタラクティブ性があるエンターテインメントという中ではやっぱりその一つ抜けてるのかなっていうふうには思っているんですね。で、でインタラクティブ性というところだけ捉えていくとですね、今コントロールパッドだったりタッチパネルだったりとかっていうふうにインターフェースが、まあ、技術の革新によってどんどん進化していくと思うので、それによる新しいその遊びっていうのが生まれてくるでしょうし、あと今そのPC の性能とかどんどん良くなってるんですけど、どんどん絵の方向だけにこう絵がどんどん綺麗になっていくみたいな感じになっていくんですけども、これをもうちょっとゲームの方に寄せていくと、今までできなかったもうなんかアホみたいに数が出てくる敵とかみたいな、そんな感じで新しい遊びがまだ進化していくと思っています。なのでゲームの可能性という意味ではまだまだこの序の口なんではないかというところで、これも今後もっと発展していくんじゃないかなというふうには思っています。でゲームを作っていくっていうことは、作る環境が整っていくということは、どんどんゲームも今度インディーとかでどんどん増えていくと思うんですよね。そうすると今度新しいパブリッシャーさん、例えばワンテンさんとかみたいなパブリッシャーさんがどんどん増えてきてですね、そのゲーム業界がどんどん活性化していくと思うんですよね。なのでそういうところにはやっぱ頑張ってほしいかなというふうに思います。
Hi, my name is Stephanie Yosten. This is a day I've been looking forward to for the past 6 months or so. Last winter, I joined a new project as the Associate Creative Director and started working day and night with an amazing group of people from around the world. We set out to imagine a powerful and moving single-player story that is bold, fresh, exciting, and will leave you hanging on the edge of your seats.Our brilliant development team was given the job to craft a completely new experience by blending themes and genres in unexpected ways and innovate on the industry standards as we've known them so far. We are creating an emotional spectacle like you've never seen or played before. This is more than just a game, and I cannot be more excited to give you the first look.